Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to create a class diagram for ATM system. So let's get started. So I'm currently having my star UML software over here. So after opening it, you need to go to model and you need to go to add diagram. So here you'll be having the option called as class diagram. If I just click on that, I'll be having all the necessary shapes to draw the class diagram. So to give you the overview of the diagram, I will be having some of the classes like customer, account, card, transaction, ATM, that machine itself. Okay, so these are going to be some of the classes. So first let me begin with the customer. So I'll just click on this class diagram. I'll just have it over here. So I'll be getting like this. Let me just now expand it a bit. Yeah, so I'll just name it as customer, or the person who is going to come to the ATM and withdraw the money. That's going to be our customer. And the customer is going to have a name, address, email, password, pin, so all the necessary details. Okay, so you need to just right click the particular class and to go to add. So you'll be having the option called as attribute. Just click it. So my first attribute is going to be the customer name. Okay, so these are the details that the customer like has or will have whenever a customer is going to like put the ATM card. Okay, so it's going to be customer name. This is going to be of the type string. Yeah, I'll just click on plus. Next attribute is going to be the customer address or email. So you can just have it address. This is address, email, like you can just write it down. Okay, it's repeat address, email and phone number. I will go with phone number or something. Yeah, this is going to be of type string as well. And next important thing is going to be the customer's card and account. So it's going to be card number. Maybe you can put card number, something like that. Card number. This is also going to be of type string because it's such a large number. Maybe string or long int, it's your choice. I will go with string. And next one is going to be the account number. Okay, so this account number, like, it's not necessary over here because the customer is not dealing with a bank account or something. The customer is just going to like insert the card, so card number is fine over here. So next, in case of operations, there are like so many operations, so I'll just right click add. I will go with operation. So the first operation of our customer is going to be inserting the card. So that's how it begins in the ATM system. That's the first initial starting point. So it's going to be insert card. Yeah, so this is going to be the first one. And the next one is going to be the select, enter the pin. Okay, entering. Okay, I'll just add another one. Enter pin. Okay, enter pin for that particular card. After that, the customer needs to like select the account type. Select account type, whether it is like a savings account or a current account, and enter amount to be withdrawn from the bank. Yeah, that's going to be next one. And after that, there are some, in some ATMs the customer can even transfer money from one account to another account. So in case of that ATMs, it's going to be transfer amount. This feature, I guess, is not available in all the ATMs. So next one, final thing is going to be withdraw the cash and receipt. Yeah, if everything goes well, withdraw cash and the customer can leave the ATM. So this is basically the customer class. I think I have added the necessary things. So why I'm not adding here more card number and more details is because I will be having separate classes for our class and transaction and other stuff. So that's why I'm not like over bombarding with the customer class itself. So I'll just click on class and I'll just have it. So here I will be having my ATM card, the card that is going, the customer is going to insert, ATM card itself. I will just expand it. I think the diagram is going to be up here so large. So there are like so many classes. So it's going to be, I'll just add, I'll just click on add attribute. The first attribute obviously is going to be the, it is going to be the number, card number. Okay, card number. So you can have this of type string or long int. I will have it long int, pretty much long int. Yeah, that's good, I guess. I will just change here as well to int or long int. It's your choice. Int or long int. Yeah. So this is fine. And next one is going to be the bank name. So let me just now add. Okay, let's add. Attribute is going to be the type of the card. Type of the card, you can just add bank name of the card. Like there are so many things. I'll go with bank name. You can add type of the card if you want to. Bank name, this is going to be of type string. And next one is going to be the expiry date. Okay, the date through which the particular card is valid. So it's going to be expiry date. We will have a range of date, right? So it's going to be of type date. Don't put string over there. You need to put date for that. So we are done with this. And in case of like operations, the only operation that a card, it card does is that it basically like gets our account on the ATM machine. So it's giving our account. So we will be using the ATM card to like get our account. Okay, so gives our account. So I will just go with get our account. That's it. So this is a function of ATM card. So next one is going to be the ATM machine itself, like the big, large, metallic machine. Okay. So I'll just click on class and I'll just have it. So it's going to be the ATM machine. Yeah. Just expand it a bit now. So I'll just click on add attributes. So first thing, the ATM machine will like display the customer's card, okay, card number that is getting scanned after the customer insert a particular card. So it's going to be card number over here as well, which is going to be of type long int. And after that, the ATM machine will prompt for an, what do you call, font for the pin or the password, okay. So it's going to be pin number. And I think you can go with, for pin number, it's going to be of type only int, because I think pin is like very small in size, so int will be fine. And the ATM machine also has a location, and what you call location and the bank name embedded to it. So every time when you go to an ATM, it's going to have its own location and a bank name attached to it. So it's going to be location. So this is going to be of type string. And next one is going to be the bank name. So there are like, in some cases, there's going to be like a bank specific ATM. Okay. So it's going to be also of type string. Yeah. So we are done with the attributes. And next one is going to be the functions of an ATM. There are like tons of functions that an ATM machine is performing. I will just limit it to the important ones, okay? So I will just add operation. So first important function is of the ATM is to validate, okay? Or validate or read the card. Yeah, that's how it begins, right? Reading the card, read the card. Yeah, basically like when a user inserts the card, the ATM machine must be able to read the particular card number, scan it. So that's how it starts. And next one is going to be validation, okay? Validation, whether the user has entered the correct pin for that particular card. So validation, that's one important thing. And next one is going to be user input. Okay, user input. This input is going to be of both selecting the account type, whether it is going to be a savings account or a current account, as well as getting the money to be withdrawn. So this is going to be the user input. So basically this has everything, every input that the user is going to give from pin till the amount that is getting withdrawn. So, and next one is going to be process the transaction, okay? So once the user is done with entering the amount, next thing that the bank needs to do is like process the transaction. It needs to like connect with the backend bank database and check the credentials of the user and check if the entered amount is greater than the bank balance. If everything goes fine, the ATM machine will give the cash. So that comes inside process transaction. So after that, it's simple, give money and give the receipt. Okay, and yeah, I think this is fine, like to be honest, yeah. So just click it, add, it's going to be operation, and I will have here it as give money, okay, like give the cash or something like that, give cash, that's much better. So just imagine yourself as if you're inside an ATM, like just personify yourself as if you're doing that. It will be much more easy and you will be having a good workflow, you know, like the step-by-step process if you imagine that way. So generate receipt, I will just have it as generate receipt. Use camel case, like I'm not using camel case in many places. So use camel case if you're having like this way. Yeah, it will be much more understandable. So these are things that we have for our ATM machine. So this is fine. So next one is going to be our transaction. So what I meant by transaction is that transaction is a thing that happens when our ATM machine communicates with our bank database, the backend bank database. Okay. So that's also an important thing, because without transaction, nothing is going to happen. Without that particular checking process, you know, this process transaction. Okay. That's, we need to have a separate class for that itself. So in case of a class diagram, I would always recommend you to have 5 to 7 diagrams. So if you have only 3 or 4 diagrams, it's going to look so blank. It's like it will be like amateur diagram. So I will just want you to have more number of classes. Okay, so I will go with the transaction. So this is fine. So transaction will have many details. Okay, so like I will just add the attribute. So the first attribute, the transaction, is going to have, the transaction is nothing but the data that is sent from our ATM machine to the bank server or database. So at first it will have the customer details. I will just enclose it as customer details because it will have the customer name, customer PIN, customer account number, everything, bank account, the whole details that we are having over here as well. So I will just enclose everything with the customer details. So if you want to type, you can just add customer name, customer email ID, or customer bank name, customer card number, and customer PIN. So these are customer details. If you want to write it down, you can write it out separately as well. And this is going to be the thing. And next attribute is going to be the date and time of that particular transaction is happening. Yeah, because whenever you get a receipt from the ATM machine, you will be having the time over there. So that's also sent side by side. It's going to be of type date. And the next attribute is going to be the depositor amount, or the deposited amount, or the amount to be withdrawn. Okay, so I'll go with amount. Yeah, because that also needs to be checked. Amount. And that's going to be of a type. I will go with the end. Okay, yeah. And next one is going to be the status of our transaction. This is also really important. So in case there is some failure of our ATM machine, or in case there is some failure in the bank servers, we need to get a status for that particular transaction. Status means it's true or false, successful or not. Basically, just a Boolean variable. Or in case, suppose, what if the particular user's balance is less than the amount to be withdrawn. So in case the status will be negative. Okay, status, successful or not, simple. So it's going to be status, and it's going to be of type true or false. Don't put int or string over there. Status always needs to be of type Boolean. Okay, so this is fine. So let me just now go with the operation. Yeah, first operation is going to be connecting the bank server. Okay, this is going to be the first operation, like having communicating with the bank servers always. Just click on add operation, and next one is going to be the getting the balance of the user. So in some ATMs the balance will be displayed, right? So get balance from the user. Yeah, and next one is going to be the status. Okay, status, whether the particular transaction is successful, whether the particular transaction is failure, whether you have like insufficient balance in your account. So it's going to be get status. Okay, status. Yeah, I think these are some of the details. Yeah, these are much enough for the transaction class. So the final class that I'm going to add over here is the bank system, or the bank server, or database, you can call it that way. I will go with bank system itself. So I'll just have a class. So it's going to be bank system. All right, so this is going to have the entire detail of that customer's bank card, PIN. So this will help our ATM machine to perform all the validation over there. Okay, so it's going to be, first one is going to be bank name, that's obvious. Yeah, and it's going to be the bank name of type string, and it will have all the bank details, the side by side details, location, everything, etc. That's also going to be string. And next one is going to be the user details. By user, I meant the customer details, the entire detail of a customer, card, address, email, everything is going to get stored in that particular bank system. So this is going to be users details of type string. So these are some of the attributes. I will go with the operation next. So in case of operation, the main aim of a bank to perform is initiate or help in the transaction. So the bank system also performs validation. Okay, yeah. And next one is going to be the amount validation. So this first validation was a credential validation, like the user has entered the right credentials. Second one is going to be the amount validation, which means that if the user has sufficient balance, and if the user has entered the amount to be withdrawn from the bank that is greater than the money that is present inside the bank itself. So only in that case the user will be able to get the money. If the balance is less, the transaction will be a failure. Okay, so that is the amount validation. And after that, it's just, that's the two things that the bank does, or you can just add more. I will just give add operation. Sending details, like sending the customer some balance details as well as the amount that is there in the bank, something like that. So sending details back to the ATM machine. So this is it pretty much. So now I will go with the lines. Okay, I will go with the arrow line. So it starts with customer, ATM, bank is over here. So I'll just have this over here. So it's going to be like this. I'll have it here. Yeah, so the transaction is going to be here. Yeah, This is fine now. So I'll just go with the directed association. Customer will have the ATM card, and the ATM card will be getting inserted to the ATM machine. And after that, the transaction will take place. And with the help of the transaction, the bank will like connect it. And after that, the bank will also send some transaction, like the feedback. Okay, basically the feedback from to the feedback to the ATM machine, like the details, validation, the result of the process, everything. So that's going to be a two-way over there. And after that, the transaction will be going to the ATM machine again. So this will be then in turn generated as a receipt to the customer. So this can be like the receipt. Okay, I'll just have it type it down as receipt. Yeah, receipt is getting given back to the customer. And what you notice here is that this is going to be a two-way operation. Okay, and from customer, you can like, if you don't have ATM card, from the customer and ATM machine is also going to be a two-way process. But since we are having ATM card as a class, it's going to be like more of a one-way in our class diagram, but in reality it's going to be a two-way process. So this is it. I hope this diagram is quite simple and not complex. So if you want to add more number of classes, you can have a separate class for. I've also done use case and activity diagram for many other online database management system as well as ATM machine as well. So do check the playlist of my channel, as well as I've done programming tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL. So do check them. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.